Hello, my friend. Welcome to Reflections and Music, Praying with Singers, Sinners, and Saints. Calvin Miller was born in Enid, Oklahoma, in 1936, the seventh of nine children. He found faith in 1945 at a lively Pentecostal tent meeting. There, in the smell of new sawdust, he would later write, "I met the Christ who shortly became the peer of my new faith." According to his biographical statement, years earlier, Calvin's father abandoned the family. His mother raised the children, relying on desperately meager resources and abundant creativity. To provide for her family, she worked as a laundress and often ventured to the train tracks to gather grain shaken from rail cars and then stored it away for the winter. After graduating from high school, Calvin Miller felt a call to preach and went on to Oklahoma Baptist University and Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary in preparation for his vocation. He pastored a church in New Hampshire for 6 years, clearly outside of the Bible Belt, and then became the pastor of Westside Church in Omaha, Nebraska in 1966. He served there for 25 years, growing the church from 10 members to 3,000. He would eventually become a professor of preaching and pastoral ministry at Sanford's Beeson Divinity School in Birmingham, Alabama, before dying at the age of 75 following complications of open-heart surgery. He was a prolific writer, best-selling author, poet, and artist. In the early years of my ministry as a young pastor, I looked to Calvin Miller as someone I wanted to emulate, although I was not blessed with any of his incredible talents. Even so, I often quoted his humorous poems in my sermons at Orlando Baptist Church. I attempted to use humor and creativity in my homilies, as Calvin Miller did. In fact, one Sunday, the title of my message was Aliens in Orlando. Later that week, one of my parishioners said to me, "When my 9-year-old son opened the worship bulletin and saw the title, Aliens in Orlando, he said to me, 'Well, you know there's going to be an interesting poem in this sermon.'" And I remember thinking that perhaps I was using too many poems by Calvin Miller in my sermons. I wrote a letter once to Calvin Miller asking him for some guidance on how I might go about hosting an arts festival at my church, as he did every year at his church in Omaha, Nebraska. I loved reading all of his books, but especially the Singer Trilogy, an allegory on the life of Jesus about a singer who sang songs of love and redemption. I also enjoyed his book, Fred and Irma, A Humorous Look at Church Life. He wrote more than 40 books of fiction, nonfiction, and poetry, all deeply spiritual and meaningful. He believed that humor and laughter reflect our comfort with a holy God. Many believers, he said, flagellate themselves into a worm theology, never quite happy or productive. People of prayer, he argued, laugh easily. When I was in seminary, I applied for a youth minister position at Calvin Miller's church and even flew to Omaha for an interview. I was excited just to meet Calvin Miller, not to mention the possibility of serving alongside him at his church. I asked the associate pastor, "How should I address him? What do people in the church call him? Pastor Miller? Brother Miller? Dr. Miller?" "No," he laughed and said, "just Calvin." Everybody calls him Calvin. I remember thinking at the time that it was an example of his humility. Despite his great success as a best-selling author and as the pastor of a large church, he was just Calvin. Perhaps there's a lesson there for us, especially as it relates to prayer, to not take ourselves too seriously and to live with humility, humor, and grace. Several years ago, Kate and I saw the Moody Blues in concert. They ambled decrepitly onto the stage, slowly picked up their instruments, and then tore into a rocking rendition of their song, "I'm Just a Singer in a Rock and Roll Band." I read once that this song was an answer to the Beatles and the backlash they faced when John Lennon said that they were more popular than Jesus, which may have very well been true for the young people of England at the time. Even so, John Lennon would later say in an interview that it was wrong of him to make such a statement. So, the Moody Blues, if this story is true, were simply making an humble statement when they sang, "I'm just a singer in a rock and roll band." And, as Calvin Miller might say, in reference to his book, The Singer, "I'm just a troubadour singing a love song to God."